Good morning, students. Today we will start the topic of subscription from chapter 1, not-for-profit organizations. In last class we have discussed receipt payment account, income expenditure and balance sheet. Now we will do the specific item related to numericals. For example, in today's class we will cover the topic subscription of numericals. One thing is common in all numericals, that is adjustment. One thing is common in all adjustment, in all questions, that is called adjustment. For example, in 11th class, you have earlier studied outstanding will be plus and prepaid will minus. But in 12th class, you have double amount of outstanding and double amount of advance. So, whatever the treatment you learn in class 11, use for single item. And other item, the treatment will be reversed. For example, if you add the outstanding at the end, outstanding at the end will be plus, so outstanding in the beginning will be minus, and advance is vice versa, means advance at the end minus and advance in the beginning is plus. These adjustments common in all special items like subscriptions, consumable stores, salaries, etc. There are four adjustments. I repeat these adjustments. These are common in every question. Outstanding end will be plus and outstanding beginning will be minus. Advance received at the end will be minus and advance received in beginning plus. Now we will start the question of NCRT, page number 22 and question number 5. Page number 22 and question number 5. Now I read the question. As per receipt payment account, for the year ended on March 31st, 17, the subscription received were ₹2,50,000. Additional information given is as follows. Subscription outstanding on 1st April 2016 is 50,000. Subscription outstanding on 31st March 17, 35,000. Subscription received in advance as on 1/4/16 is 25,000 and subscription received in advance as on 31st March 17 is 30,000. Ascertain the amount of income from subscription for the year ended 2016-17 and show the relevant items of subscription appear in opening and closing balance sheet. You have read the question very carefully. What is demanded by the question? In solution, aapko question bahut dhyan se padhna hai. क्वेश्चन सॉल्यूशन में आपसे चाह क्या रहा है, क्या मांग रहे क्वेश्चन आपसे, उसके अकॉर्डिंग आपको सॉल्व करना है. इन दिस क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन डिमांड द फॉलोइंग इन सॉल्यूशन. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू असर्टेन द इनकम फॉर सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर द ईयर 16-17 एंड नेक्स्ट हाउ द रिलेवेंट आइटम ऑफ सब्सक्रिप्शन अपीयर इन द ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंस शीट. दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी डन बाय टू मेथड्स, by accounting method or by statement method. In this question, we will do this question by both method. First, we are using the accounting method. So, prepare the subscription account. Left side is debit and right side is credit. Particular amount. After that, you write balance BD, balance brought down, means outstanding beginning. Why outstanding beginning at debit side? Outstanding subscriptions means subscription receivable in future. And whatever we receivable in future is called asset. Asset is the amount receivable in future. So outstanding subscription is asset. And subscription received in advance. You have received the subscription in advance and now you have to fulfill the purpose for which subscription will be received. So the subscription received in advance is liability. Other जो सब्सक्रिप्शन आउटस्टैंडिंग है, फ्यूचर में आपको पैसे मिलने हैं, अभी मिले नहीं है, फ्यूचर में मिलने हैं, और मिलने तो मनी क्या है, एसेट, एडवांस मतलब आपको मिल चुके हैं और अब आपने क्या करना है, उसके लिए काम करना है, तो क्या हो गया, ये आपका लायबिलिटी. एसेट्स ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑलवेज द डेबिट बैलेंस एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंस इज क्रेडिट बैलेंस. लायबिलिटीज इज वाइस वर्सा, ओपनिंग बैलेंस इज क्रेडिट बैलेंस एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंस इज डेबिट बैलेंस. Now, read the statement of the question once again. Subscription received 2,50,000. What is the journal entry for subscription received? Yes, bank account debit to subscription account. Means, subscription account will be credited. So, subscription account credited ₹2,50,000 by cash. You have received subscription received during the year. So cash is 2,50,000. Cash is 2,50,000. After that, see the additional information. Subscription outstanding on 1/4/16. In this question, your financial year is 16-17. In this question, your financial year will be 16 and 17. So 16 is beginning and 17 is end. So, subscription outstanding on 1/4/16 means subscription outstanding in beginning. Outstanding subscription will be asset and beginning of asset is debit. So, balance BD, outstanding subscription is 50,000. After that, subscription outstanding at end. So, closing balance of asset will be credit balance. Balance CD of asset or subscription. Outstanding end is 35,000. After that, subscription received in advance on 1/4/16. Matlab advance received in beginning. Beginning and liability balance is beginning. Beginning liability balance will be credit. So balance BD is 25,000. And after that, next is subscription received in advance on 31/17. This is the closing balance, advance at end. Closing balance, liabilities, closing balance is debit side. So the amount balance CD is 30,000 put here. After that, total the amount, add the and get the balancing figure. Balancing figure will be transferred to income and expenditure amount, ₹2,30,000. Balancing figure will be transferred to income and expenditure account, ₹2,30,000. See, if cash received is given in the question, then you can find out the income expenditure as a balancing figure. If income expenditure is given in the question, then you can get the cash as a balancing figure. And same for other items also. Whatever you have given on the basis of these items, you have get the missing figure. So this is the accounting method of subscription. Now we will do this question by alternative method called statement method. Now we will doing this question by statement method. In statement, what is the difference between statement accounts method? In accounting method, there is two sides, debit and credit side. But in statement method, there is only one side. You write the amount only one side. This is called statement method. Formula or principle is same. Subscription received 2,50,000. Subscription received 2,50,000. I have discussed earlier. Subscription at the end, outstanding 31/3/17 will be 35,000. subscription at the end will be plus. So subscription at the beginning, subscription outstanding beginning will be minus. Opposite, subscription outstanding on 1/4/16 is 50,000. Subscription outstanding 31/3/17 will be plus, and subscription outstanding on 1/4/16 will be minus or deduct. After that, subscription advance on 1/4/16. This is the beginning subscription. If end advance subscription outstanding at the end will be plus, so subscription outstanding end will be plus, so subscription advance beginning will be plus, vice versa, na, opposite sides. If subscription outstanding end will be plus, so advance at beginning will be plus. And if subscription beginning is minus, so subscription at the end is minus. Ek to isme kya hoga? Ek cheez aap learn kar lijiye. Subscription outstanding at the end learn kar lo. Aapko pata lag gaya subscription outstanding at the end kya hota hai, hamesha plus hota hai. इसकी डिटेल हम 11th में कर चुके हैं. आप देखना चाहो तो देख सकते हो कि आउटस्टैंडिंग क्यू प्लस होता है और प्रीपेड क्यू माइनस होता है, वो हम डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. अब हम 12th क्लास में पढ़ रहे हैं और हम 11th से आगे वाला कर रहे हैं. तो सब्सक्रिप्शन आउटस्टैंडिंग एंड वाला जो है प्लस होता है, ये हमने 11th में सीखा हुआ है. एक चीज याद कर लो, तो सब्सक्रिप्शन बिगनिंग वाला क्या होगा? माइनस, क्योंकि आउटस्टैंडिंग प्लस हुआ है बिगनिंग एंड वाला, तो एडवांस कौन सा प्लस होना तो है. एडवांस भी एक प्लस और एक माइनस है. तो अगर आउटस्टैंडिंग एंड वाला प्लस है तो एडवांस कौन सा होगा? बिगनिंग वाला. अपोजिट हो गया ना. इस तरह से आउटस्टैंडिंग बिगनिंग वाला माइनस है तो एडवांस कौन सा माइनस होगा? एंड वाला माइनस होगा. एक याद कर लो, उसके अपोजिट में आपकी चारों फिगर्स कैलकुलेट हो जाएंगे. देन ऐड दिस आइटम्स 35, 25, 250, यू विल गेट द अमाउंट इज 3,10,000. एंड डिडक्ट दिस आइटम्स, यू विल गेट द अमाउंट इज 2,30,000 इनकम फ्रॉम सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर 16-17. This is the subscription due transfer to income and expenditure account. This is the subscription due transfer to income and expenditure account. The answer will be same in both methods, in last method and in this method. So learn the one tip that outstanding end will be plus, outstanding beginning minus. Very good. If outstanding end plus, so advance beginning plus. If outstanding end plus, so advance is beginning plus. Vice versa, na, opposite wale plus hote hain. If advance beginning plus, so advance end is minus. Very good. So the answer is 2,30,000. One part is left of this question. Show the relevant items, means outstanding or prepaid subscription in balance sheet. As in question number, last class question, we have to do the question number 4. You see in that question that there are two balance sheet, opening and closing balance sheet. So write the outstanding and advance according to the year in opening balance sheet and closing balance sheet. Okay. Now the last part of this question, show the relevant items in balance sheet. So relevant items is what? Outstanding and advance. So here two balance sheet. Balance sheet as on 31st March 2017 and balance sheet as on 1st April 2016. So balance sheet as on 31st March 2017, we write the figures of 31st March 2017. In 31st March 2017, subscription outstanding is 35,000 and subscription advance on 31st March 2017 is 30,000. Outstanding subscription right at asset side and subscription advance right at liability side. After that, balance sheet on 1/4/16 means opening balance sheet or beginning balance sheet. So subscription outstanding on 1/4/16 is 50,000. So right at asset side, and subscription advance 25,000 right at liability side. What is the reason of subscription outstanding advance asset liability? Because outstanding receivable in future, so we receive the benefit in future, that's why it is asset. And in that case, subscription received in advance, we have to do the work, we have to provide the service, that's why it is our liability to provide the service, obligation to do the service in future. So the question number 5 is completed. NCERT page number 2. Yes, we have completed question number 5, page number 22. We have completed. Now, we will start the question number 6 of NCERT, page number 23. I am reading the question for you. Extract of receipt payment account for the year end 31st March 17 below. Receipt subscriptions amount given is 2500, 26750, 1000, total is 30,250. And adjustment given is total number of members 230. Annual subscription fee is 125. Subscription outstanding on 1st April 2016 2750. Prepare a statement showing all relevant items of subscription via income, advance, outstanding, etc. Read the question carefully. अब question इसमें आपसे क्या demand कर रहे हैं? आपको relevant items सारे show करने हैं subscription के. Income है, advance है, outstanding है, whatever जो भी है. We have discussed at the time of question number 5, we can use that accounting method or statement method. So, if question demand, then you can use accounting method. Otherwise, statement method will be okay. So, if you have a choice, do the question by statement method. So, when the members are given in the question and subscription due given in the question per member, first you have to calculate the total amount of subscription due. If members and subscription of per member, total member, and subscription of per member given in the question, then first we have to calculate amount of subscription due. So there are 230 members, amount of per members is 230 and amount due is 125. So total amount of subscription due is 28,750. Do you know where this amount will be shown? Yes, very good. Due amount will be shown in income and expenditure amount. Due amount will be shown in income and expenditure. And where the amount received shown in which account? Where the amount received shown in which account? Yes, receipt and payment account. So, in this question you have write this like formula is same. Statement method, you can compare with previous question also. Subscription received according to receipt payment is 30,250. Add subscription outstanding 31st March 17. This is not given in the question. You have to calculate by working note number 1. I will prepare working note number 1 after that, after completing this term. So, subscription outstanding on 31st March 17 is 2250 with the help of working note number 1. You will see working note number 1 after completed this statement. So, subscription outstanding 31st 317 is 2250, subscription end, and subscription advance beginning, will be nil, no information. Subscription outstanding on beginning is 2750, see the adjustment, yes see, subscription outstanding on April 1st 2016 is 2750. This is the subscription at the beginning. Outstanding beginning. After that, see subscription advance on end. This is seen the receipt payment account. Amount is 2017-18, 1000. So, because the year is 2017-18, means advance. So, advance is 1000. This is the advance at the end. Because this is the payment for the year ending 31st March 17 for the year 17-18. At the end of the year, 31st March 17 ko, aapne year end mein jo payment ki hai, wo kis saal ke liye ki hai? 17-18 ke liye, next year ke liye. To ye aapka end ka advance ho jayega. Advance kya ho gaya aapka? 1000. So, answer will be, of this statement, answer is 28750. So, income from subscription for the year. Income from subscription for the year 2016 and 17 is 28750. You have already calculated the amount 28750 by simply members into subscription, and you also get the amount 28750 with the help of statement method. So your answer is correct. You can tally your answer by cross of these items, both 28750 and 28750. Okay, now we will do the working note. Okay, how we can calculate 2250 subscription outstanding on 31st March 17 2250. Working note number 1. Working note number 1. See the question. See at the adjustment, subscription due on 1/4/16 is 2750. Now see the receipt payment account. During the year 16-17, you have received rupees 2500. Out of the amount due in the beginning of the year, you have received 2500. So 250 is still due. You have not received during the year 250. 250 is still due. Abhi bhi ye outstanding hai. 250 is still outstanding. Now subscription due in the year 16-17, you have earlier calculated 28750. You have calculated at the top of the question and see the received. You have received the amount in 16-17. See the question, receipt payment. Receipt payment is 26750. Means due amount is 28750, but you receive for the current year 16-17 26750. Upper amount means 16-17 for the 15-16 for the previous year, 17-18 for next year, for the current year you have received the amount 26750. So 2000 is still outstanding for the current year. So total outstanding during the current year is 250 is still outstanding for the previous year, and 2000 is still outstanding for the current year. So total amount at your balance sheet outstanding is 2250. It will be transferred to income and expenditure account subscription outstanding at the end. This is the total of subscription outstanding of previous year and current year 250 and 2000. Total amount is 2250. Okay. The amount of subscription is completed, statement method. Now we will see the relevant items in balance sheet. How you can show? In this question, it is not demanded the balance sheet. But for your knowledge, I will do these items by balance sheet also. Only for your knowledge, I show the items in balance sheet also. Otherwise, question not demanded. You need not to calculate in this question. But only for your knowledge, I will tell you. This is the opening balance sheet. Balance sheet as on 1/4/16. And this is the closing balance sheet as on 31st March 17. 31st March 17. This is the opening balance sheet and this is the closing balance sheet. Okay. Subscription outstanding. See the adjustment. Subscription outstanding at the beginning of the year 2750. And subscription outstanding at the end of the year 2250. You have calculated this subscription with the help of working note. So you know very well how you calculate this amount. 15-16 is outstanding, 250 balance still outstanding because total amount is 2750 and you have received 2500 during the year. So left amount is 250, and for the current year total amount is due 28750, but you received 26750. So the amount is outstanding 2000, total of this 2250. Subscription outstanding at the end is 2250. And subscription advance at the end is 1000. Subscription advance in the beginning is not given. So today we will complete two questions, 5 and 6, related to the topic of subscription. And you have to do the related questions from NCERT book. Practice the questions. In next class, we will do with new topic of this chapter is called a fund-based accounting. Thank you.